Hello everyone, my name is Fallout, and today we're going to talk about Bloom. Bloom is a video game mechanic implemented into many FPS games, and it's very often an incredibly dividing and controversial topic in the majority of those communities. Let's go over what exactly Bloom is, and the discussions and arguments that it frequently creates. So, what is Bloom? You can think of Bloom as a self-imposed punish mechanic for firing your weapon too quickly. To really understand how it works, take a look at this. Like most other FPS games out there, weapons in Destiny 2 come with a reticle located in the center of your HUD. Your reticle shows you the cone of fire of your weapon. What that means is that when you pull the trigger, the bullet you fire is going to land somewhere within the cone of fire. It might not always be at the dead center, but the shot will be within the cone of fire. Determining where exactly in the cone the bullet will land is all up to RNG, or as it's more commonly known, luck. ADSing, or aiming down at the sight of your weapon, will tighten the cone of fire, making it more narrow. Depending on the type of weapon you have, this could either be very noticeable or not really that much. Back to what I mentioned earlier, Bloom is a punish mechanic for firing your weapon too quickly. Firing your weapon at its maximum rate of fire expands the crosshair with every shot, and with it, the cone of fire. With a very widely extended cone of fire, the bullet that you now shoot could land anywhere here within the crosshair. That is a really large area. But now, look at what happens when you fire your weapon slowly. The crosshair blooms out when you fire, but slowly shrinks back down over time. And therein lies the nature of Bloom. Much like the lifeguard who yells at people to not walk quickly around the outside of the pool, Bloom's very nature is to ensure that players fire their weapons slower and to pace their shots, or else you'll expand your cone of fire and feel the wrath of RNG-based inaccuracy. With the examples I've shown here, we've only really looked at hipfire-based Bloom, but the mechanic still does exist in many games even when ADSing. Take a look at the following example, with this hand cannon from Destiny 2, the Service Revolver. The weapon, by nature, has an extremely vertical recoil pattern. Even when firing at the absolute maximum rate of fire, though, we can see two things happening. One, the reticle continuing to expand even while in ADS mode, and two, the bullet patterns not being perfectly grouped dead center. Granted, they are still relatively tightly bunched towards the center, but the Bloom mechanic is still there. It's important to keep in mind that Bloom is not recoil. Recoil refers to the continuing upwards kick of a weapon the more that you fire it. When paired together with Bloom, it can make for a difficult overall weapon experience for any game. It's one of the reasons why console Destiny players have gravitated more towards 180 RPM hand cannons in PvP. They're easier to use overall due to more manageable recoil patterns. Dealing with just one difficult in-game mechanic is far less of a headache than having to deal with two. So, what arguments are commonly brought up due to weapon Bloom? This probably depends on what community and what game you're discussing, but a lot of the arguments brought up surrounding Bloom all touch on pretty much the same common theme, RNG. RNG, or again, luck, is directly tied to how Bloom fundamentally works. The location of exactly where your bullet will land within the weapon's firing cone is essentially a coin toss, and for a lot of players, this is where frustrations can rise. Halo Reach featured a weapon with a lot of inherent Bloom, the DMR, or the Designated Marksman Rifle. Imagine the following scenario. You're playing Halo Reach, and you suddenly find yourself in a one-on-one engagement with another player. Both of you have DMRs, and there is no cover at all nearby for either player. With this weapon, it takes 5 shots to kill. 4 will completely break an enemy's shield, and the 5th shot, provided it's in the head, will kill your enemy. You are player A. Your enemy is player B. In this scenario, you get off the first shot and start shooting player B before he starts shooting you back. By less than 1 second, let's say. Both of you are firing your weapons at the maximum fire rate. That might cause a lot of Bloom, but because you're at mid-range, you're both confident you can land shots. Now, you hit player B with the 4th shot breaking his shield, and again, not even a second later, player B hits your shields with his 4th shot breaking your shield. You know that a fifth headshot will kill player B for good, but because of the intense bloom, you hesitate to let your bloomed out reticle shrink back down so you can pace and more accurately land your final kill shot. Player B knows that he doesn't have time to pace his fifth shot because he's already behind in the shot count. Player B knows his only chance at winning the engagement is to continue spamming his shots and cross his fingers that the bloom RNG will be in his favor. Let's say, in this example, that is exactly what happens. While player A is waiting for the reticle to shrink down, player B spams his fifth shot, and even though the bloom is in full effect and very wide, he gets lucky, and his final shot hits player A right in the head, and the engagement is over. Player B essentially threw caution to the wind and put his faith in RNG for the win. Now, it's important to know that this outcome will not always happen. Since bloom is tied to RNG, there are going to be plenty of times in this hypothetical scenario that player B will miss his fifth spammed shot due to RNG and his very wide cone of fire, and player A will finish him off with the well-placed headshot. But the point is, the fact that players can have their engagements potentially determined by RNG is what gets annoying. Rewind the scenario. Maybe player A has been playing for a long time, and he's been in this exact situation before. He knows that player B is going to go for the lucky fifth headshot via trigger spam, so player A decides he isn't going to wait for the reticle to shrink down after his fourth shot. He would rather eat a pint cone then lose a gunfight to reticle RNG, so he keeps spamming his shots as well, trying to get himself a lucky fifth kill shot before player B can get his. Now you have two players spamming their shots at each other rather than pacing them for fear of essentially losing to bad RNG. That's a very specific example, but it does highlight what players dislike about bloom. It introduces more RNG into the game. Having your in-game engagements being affected by RNG takes away from engagements being won purely by skill. Games like Mario Party have tons of minigames which require concentration and timing, but there are plenty of situations in the game that are straight up RNG. These are party games, and while they're definitely entertaining to enjoy with friends on the couch and maybe with a few drinks, I very much doubt that a game like Mario Party would ever take the center stage of a major video game tournament. The more RNG gets introduced into a PvP game, the less competitive it becomes. While weapon bloom in most FPS games, including Destiny, obviously doesn't reach the level of RNG absurdity seen in games like Mario Party, it still is a factor that can affect the outcome of an engagement, which in turn has the potential to affect the outcome of a game. It's worth mentioning that even with bloom theoretically removed from most FPS games, this wouldn't completely remove bullet RNG altogether. Remember that bullet RNG comes standard within any weapon cone of fire. While some cones of fire are minuscule and others are naturally wider, which usually depends on the type of gun you're wielding, bloom simply adds even more RNG onto the pile by continuously expanding the cone. In my own experiences, I've found that by a pretty wide majority, most dedicated FPS players frown on the existence of the bloom mechanic. So with that in mind, why is it still so prevalent in the current gaming landscape? One way of thinking is that it's directly implemented as a way to protect lower level players. If FPS games universally rolled out with zero bloom across the board, it would no longer encourage players to fire slower and pace their shots, and therefore would drastically increase the overall pace of the game. In fast-paced environments, more often than not, higher skilled players thrive even more than they already do, and lower skilled players tend to get overwhelmed and drown in the action. Another theory is that it can be seen as more, quote, realistic. Trying to fire an actual firearm as accurately as you can in real life requires you to take your time and concentrate. Of course, the counter argument to that might be realism does not directly translate to the most entertaining or engaging video game experience. If games were based purely on reality, we wouldn't have the absurd entertainment of Super Smash Bros., Rocket League, Overwatch, Pokemon, or pretty much any other competitive video game you could possibly mention. If you're asking me personally, I definitely don't enjoy having high levels of bloom on my weapon. The key word in that sentence, though, might be the word high. Some people might not realize right away that Bloom exists as a sliding scale. In fact, one of my favorite FPS games of all time, Halo Combat Evolved, did feature a smaller degree of Bloom in PvP, even on the game's most celebrated weapon, the almighty three-tap pistol. However, the Bloom on Halo CE's pistol isn't discussed anywhere near as much as the Bloom from later Halo games, especially Reach, likely because the Bloom on Halo Reach's DMR is so strong it becomes immediately noticeable, even to players genuinely unfamiliar with the mechanic. FPS games are a tricky beast, though. There could be several other factors at play to explain why the Bloom on Halo CE's pistol is relatively unnoticeable in-game. Aim assist, hitboxes, firing cones, and weapon recoil can all factor into whether a weapon is overall easy or difficult to use. For the most part, anything that's purpose is to directly slow down the pace of a game, and especially to introduce luck into the equation, isn't something that sits well with a lot of people. Imagine a fighting game where landing too many combos in a row too quickly would result in a 10% chance that your character would suffer an asthma attack. I know that's a gross oversimplification, but I do think it might be time to collectively take a harder look at the mechanic itself. I'm sure that for a lot of developers, there's the fear that if Bloom were rolled back too much or outright removed altogether, that very accurate players would run the gauntlet and take over the game. But I'd argue that there's more to being good at FPS games than just accuracy alone. It unquestionably plays a major role in a player's overall skill set, but map control, micro movement, resource management, teamwork, communication, and general strategy are also heavy factors in the complete picture of what makes a player good. If anything, I hope this video helped you get a better understanding of what exactly Bloom is in FPS games, and that it might lead to a more informed discussion about its implementation in games today. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by clicking the like button, and maybe even subscribe. If you'd like to talk about Bloom in general, get a conversation going down below in the comment section. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.